My and Terry and Madeline, and I suspect Sue and Meg have made the decision to relocate in this special place that we call Yonkers, and to share with us their very special private time, their second anniversary of freedom. And we appreciate that ever so much. We cannot express just how much we appreciate that.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. I am very pleased to be here tonight. Of course, I'm pleased to be most anywhere these days. As you just heard, this is the second anniversary of my coming home, my return to freedom. But now, 2 years ago tonight, I was sitting in a small room somewhere in the Pecan Valley of Lebanon, wearing a pair of Chinese-made white boxer shorts and a t-shirt, planning very hard that what I'd been told about my imminent release was true. It's a long way from there to here. Like the lady who talked about being rich and being poor, it's a hell of a lot better here than it was there. I was born in Ohio, but I consider myself a New Yorker. We came here when I was a very small boy, about 5 or 6 years old. We moved to Albion, New York, a small town in western New York, the other side of Rochester. It's not really a town even, it's a village, 5,000 people. There wasn't much there, there still isn't actually, what's going on in town. But one thing there was on Main Street in Albion was a library, a three-story stone, rather elegant structure, built chock-a-block with books. We were rather poor in those days. We didn't have much money, and although I had learned to read at about 3 years old and loved to read, we didn't have money to buy books. So as you can imagine, I spent a lot of time at that small library on Main Street in Albion. Remember the librarian, I don't remember her name, but I remember her being there. What I considered a middle-aged lady, she must have been at least 30. Rather stern, not unfriendly, she was quite helpful, but she was very serious, quite rightly. Anybody who knew what was in all those wonderful books should be serious. But she did help me a great deal find the books that I enjoyed, that I really wanted to read. Books like Black Stallion series. Remember that? How many of you read that? Farley. Boy Life on the Prairie. The Leather Stocking Tales. Marvelous books. There was a whole genre known as the Erie Canal books about New York State in the early 19th century, the Erie Canal. I learned so much about the history of New York, about the Indians, the Iroquois Federation, the Dutch, the English, the Revolution. New York's part in the Civil War. Later, there in Albion, in the nearby town, somewhat larger, not very much, in Batavia, where I went to junior high school. In high school, other librarians introduced me to people like Steinbeck, Hemingway, Sandburg's Lincoln, Fitzgerald, so many other people. People who taught me about things like character, principle, about loyalty and patriotism. People who helped to form my character as much as my family did. And that was a very important thing, something that that young woman in Albion, and the later librarians who helped me, had a large part in.